everyone, and welcome back to Princess Connectory Dive. This will be the very final gash of the year, obviously, because we are on the 31st of December. And we are here today to roll for the new duo, Shizuru and Rino. Shizurino, if you want to abbreviate the name. But before that, before we jump into the gacha and catch up on the latest news, etc., I want to offer a moment to give a massive shout out to a viewer who gave me my very first Super Thanks donation. So, the donation was on the latest video of the main story, and I want to say very fitting because the latest main story has the Phoenix, the new character, which is a rebirth and a renewal, which hopefully we'll get into the new year after the death of Global Prygon. Hopefully you guys have been following the channel to keep up, or maybe even playing the game in Japanese, both are very viable option. I hope that you are at least catching up with the Prygon and not giving up. So, the Big Wibowski, which is the viewer who gave me the super thanks, says, Merry Christmas, thank you for giving us endless hours of easy translation and keeping the story alive, answering us and more. It's so much nicer to come home and tune into your channel, then hunt down videos out of order in Japanese and then hold up Google Translate to do the monitor. I totally understand you, by the way. I kind of have to do it to fix the machine translation sometimes, so I do understand what you mean. And pause every few minutes to get a few lines in English. Happy New Year's too. So first of all, a massive thanks to you, a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you as well, and to every viewer watching. I want to say the Super Thanks feature is something that really helps me directly, and other than the fact that you guys watch, keep up, comment, etc., which is the main thing that I want to create discussion, to keep the game alive also to people who loved it, like myself, and had to abandon it because of the end of service of the global version, I want to really, really give you a lot of thanks because what you give me will be repurposed into making the channel better and hopefully getting more stories out. Obviously, I am a normal person like all of you guys, but whenever I see support, whenever I see you guys interacting with the channel and the game, I am also happier to give you the time that I spend on the game to make the translations better, to bring you guys characters who otherwise will be ignored because the game right now has little chances to come out in global, so my effort and hopefully other people's effort will be the best way to keep such a wonderful game alive. I love Prygon, you guys know that there are some games that I really love, Dragalia Lost, Prygon, Fate, there are a ton of games that I really want to bring to everywhere as much as I can because I do think that those are stories, characters and experiences worth having, be it as a player, be it as a viewer. I really want to say thank you, thank you, thank you very much to all the viewers and thank you the Big Wibowski for the support that you give me. I know that you love Matsuri, I will try to get the Matsuri and Christina event out as soon as possible, and I also have the Wild Matsuri, which is from that event, so you will also see her story soon. She was one of the event stories that I wanted to do very soon anyway, and since we do have the New Year, and then we have some free space, because I actually did already some older New Year stories, when we did the summer for what's his name, the fisherman, so I had to do that event and it kinda came out earlier, so we can probably squeeze it in before the anniversary. Speaking of that, let's get into the news. So today we have the New Year event with Hatsune, Kasumi and Inori, probably the most killer combo I've seen against me, because we have a duo with one of my favorites, which is Rino, and Shizuru we also like. Then we have Hatsune, one of my top 10 characters, Kasumi, one of my top 10 characters, and then we have the anniversary. I have only 20,000 gems, so what will I do? Well, pray to every god of the New Year, hopefully, and then maybe I will have to do a choice between Hatsune and Kasumi. I am leaning toward Kasumi because she's higher than Hatsune in my top 10, but I also want to say that I really like Hatsune, so I am kinda torn. I guess that will come into the 4th of January when we have to do another video with the gacha, maybe, and see how it goes, but for now it is a very dangerous situation. Well, hopefully first we need to clear the Shizurino gacha, that's the most important part today. But let's get to it rather. We do have one free roll which I saved up, obviously. And if we get it from the free roll, then we are going very calmly into the next gacha, be it Hatsune or Kasumi. But if we don't, that's a little bit more of a worry. I really love this duo, by the way. I think the outfit, they seem to be inspired by the Salazaria event, the one that with Ruga and not Saren. Yes, Saren, sorry. I said Ruga first, I thought that I said Saren first. Yes, Ruga and Saren. And I really love the Union Burst as well. Corona Reign was one of my favorite Union Burst from the original game, I mean in global technically, but it was incredibly fun to unlock when I locked the 6th arena. So without further ado, let's get into it and see if we can manage to get this new character. If we get a downloading rate here, I will be more than happy, by the way. I don't really plan to go all in on this gacha because I want to get also the other characters, so if the gods of young and older sisters are somewhere, please bless me right now. Come on. They didn't, but that's fine. So obviously this is a Preifes, so the rates are better, which is why I'm not too worried that we won't have to spark like usual. But at the same time, I do remember that I had to spark for Lyra, I think. So there is always that worry, but hopefully it won't come true. I have basically pulled every Rhino alt in existence, so I'm not too worried that she won't bless me. Let's see who we got as a dupe. Please don't be an Altar Maiden. Okay, this Vampy. I have gotten Vampy 4 times now. I know that she's also from Dragaea Lost and Rise of Bahamut and Shadowverse and Granblue Fantasy, but she has been haunting me like crazy. Okay, doesn't look like we got anything here either. She's completely fine. We still have a lot to go, but hopefully we get a downloading soon, please. Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay, so now we have to hope that it is Shih Tzu and Rino, and it's not someone else from the Preifes. I wouldn't mind getting Labirista or Omare or Rampha. Would be fine as well. But obviously we are here for Shih Tzu and Rino. So, come on. Yes! Ok, so my reaction, I was about to scream in joy, but then I thought, you know, maybe they want to hear the lines, etc. And, God damn, I'm so happy. Now, you guys don't know how much I worried over Hatsune and Kasumi and the fact that I had to roll for them as well, and also Shih Tzu and Rino. That was my first worry, ever. And I am so glad that we got those two. Look at how beautiful the alt is. I love it. I love duos, by the way. They're probably one of my favorite ideas in the game. They kinda remind me of Fire Emblem Heroes in a way, but I think that they are done way better in Precon as a whole. So, let's see actually. Actually, I don't even know what the character does. Okay, they are physical. That's fine, because both are physical in the original. They're middle. Both offense and defense. Power damage when critical. So, they're probably critical. Let's see the Union Burst. Come on. Translate it. Let me read it. 2 physical damage, restore your HP. Ok. Furthermore, extra large amount behind you, creating a field that increases your. Oh, even a field, ok. So I think they can be easily for bot modes, to be honest, because if the damage is substantial, they can go in CB or they can also do Arena. Depends how good they are in Arena. TP, ok, they are meta probably, because TP always. There is a rule in the Japanese server: if you read TP on a character, probably you want them, so I do guess that they will be very powerful. Ok, we got lucky, we got the alt, so the schedule right now, I probably want to do it like this: today Gacha and the story of Shih Tzu and Rino, tomorrow we do the event. And then rolling out in the coming days, we will get the stories, the sub-event stories, the gachas, etc. So I want to obviously get out the character story first because I want to read it, and I have less time to do the event today because obviously tonight I will go out partying, so I will probably return home being unable to record even if I get the translation in time. So having a 4-story translation is a lot more faster than I believe it is 8 story for an event, which are also pretty massive because those are 3-hour stories. But I will probably put my all into it tomorrow, so do not worry. You will get the event as well. I think that you guys also want to see the character first. Wow. My voice is going away. Not a good sign when you want to do out partying, but that's another story. So about the characters. I wanted to show you guys that actually I have quite a lot of duo. I miss Anne and Greya, but probably since we have an anniversary coming soon, I might try to spark them on the anniversary. So about the duos, we have Saren and Akino. We have where are they? I always level them up so they should be up here. Hatsune and Shiori, which also got a new unique. Which, what does it do? Gives them TP. Okay, that's going to make them a lot stronger. Did it actually give them TP before? I don't think it did. Ah, no, it did. Okay. But maybe, what is the buff? It deals more damage, okay. AoE damage as well. That's not bad at all. I actually use them in arena a lot. I really like the UB as well. So I have two duos. Now I have three, obviously, with Shizuru and Rino. And then I believe that's it. There is also Anne and Greya, and actually we can see them, I believe. So we have Anne and Greya, which I don't have, Misogi, Mimi and Kyoga, which I don't have. Those other two will be the one that I will be going for. Then obviously we have Princess Kokoro. You princess, you will get the story soon enough. I'm trying to space out your stories. Otherwise the channel will be just Saren, Yui and other character stories, which are my favorites, I know, but I don't want them to hog all the attention. Iori as well. Omare actually, ok. So before we say goodbye, for the New Year stories, we have some characters. Obviously Inori, not Katsumi. Kazumi and Hatsune, I mix them. We have also New Year Omare, which is. Where is she? There we go. New Year Omare, I got her some months ago. She's ready to go, so you guys will also see her in the stories coming up into the New Year, so next 2 weeks basically. And then, who else? Actually, I don't remember if I have a New Year alt. Let me see. So if I write New Year. Ok, very nice. So Inori, Omare, maybe we can do Muimi. Like I think that there is some point to do Muimi. Ruga as well, I would Redeemer. In terms of events, I only have the one with Sheffy remaining, which maybe I will do because it is kinda relevant to the main story. So look forward to the content coming, that's all that I can say. Anyway, my friends, this was an incredible season for Precon and the channel for me. Once again, I'm really happy about the big Wibowski and this donation to the channel that really helps a lot. So I want to say this. 2024 will be a wonderful year for Precon, I'm sure. We start with the anniversary event at the very end of January, so look forward to that. It will be a two-parter. The first part will come at the end of January, the second part in the middle of January together with the stream. We will also get the new update with the elements, which I didn't really talk about because it is pretty much a huge thing that will get its own video, but I'll probably talk about it in the next video since this one I wanted to make it more of end of the year. Thank you very much to everyone, which is hopefully what I managed to convey to you guys. Other than that, you guys know the schedule. Today we have Gacha and the character story. In the coming days, the event, tomorrow probably, but just to be sure, because if I wake up with an hangover that is the size of a mountain, then good luck to myself trying to upload it, but I should be able to. Most of the time, I manage to get through to it. Not that I go everywhere, every night at least, partying, but when I do, at least I come out being capable of uploading stuff. Maybe I get some mistakes here and there, but it is fine. As long as I get the translation right and it is readable, that's what's important to me. So that it is. Anyway, thank you very much for watching and supporting Hunterlodge through the year. I know that it was difficult with the end of Paragon. I hope that this solution is equal or if not better to what we had. Hopefully, I hope over time at least we get to experience the same. I hope. And thank you very much for the support that you've given me through 2023, and I hope you will continue supporting me through 2024. I will continue doing my work as much as I can. My work, my hobby in this case, because I don't really want to call it work, because I enjoy myself, so it is more of a hobby. And hope that you guys will be here with me. So, for 2023, thank you very much. Hopefully you guys leave a like and a sub to support the channel, And if you want to support the channel even more, like the big Webowski did, feel free to drop a super thanks whenever you want. I would really appreciate it, and it helps the channel a lot to continue this project, which was probably my second most important project on the channel after Dragadia Lost, which unfortunately left us, but it didn't leave my heart and our memories, so Pregon will be the same. I will try my best to keep it alive. Thank you, my friends. Happy New Year and happy party, dinner, whatever you are doing tonight. Anyway, thank you very much. I will see you next time. Bye, my friends.